You come in the ninth grade and you're all basically still pretty young kids, and you leave and you truly are adults.
It's quite an experience and a journey to kind of see the transition with you over the past like 4 years.
No, I'd say maybe I'm a bit confused about who he is.
You were all about this tall when you first came in, and now you're about this tall. I'll admit, we don't have the tallest students in New York City who go to this school, but I assume you mean in ways other than physical.
We met in cross country, and then
we were each other for middle school, and then
She reached out to my friends.
The four of us also had English freshman year together, so they kind of sat together in different arrangements.
My mom and I were trying to find parking, and we saw this one guy with blue hair. I'm going to use the word sauntering down the street.
Saundering is the correct
word. Yeah, so that was Isaac, and we came into the lobby, and then Isaac and I became quick. Zeke and I have known each other since third grade.
And then we just sort of like grew. And then these two are immigrants.
Yeah.
Cindy fell off her chair freshman year, which I thought was really funny. And then I was friends with these people at HSAS, and then
I was the glue.
You know, it's hard to make a good first impression on me when you're 14. You guys are like loud and boisterous, but I think what I've come to really love about your class is that you guys remain loud and boisterous and joyful.
When you guys became seniors, I was a little bit concerned just because like I didn't know a lot of you. Now I've gotten to know almost all of you, and it's really been a great experience. You guys are great kids.
Best. We're like clearly superior. Just like everybody.
It's just a great grade.
I feel like our grade is made up of superstars.
They're all people.
I think it's the little personalities everywhere. It's like the people that you see in the morning and you'll say hi to them. Like, and maybe you don't want to be the best friends with them,
right.
But
uh-huh.
You'll say hi, you'll share that smile, and you know that you're in a safe place.
And I think there's like a sense of family because we're so small, and like even though we all like really strive and really competitive, especially academically, I feel like we all like to help each other out.
I know in the beginning of the year, there was a lot of affirmations being thrown around on the big screen at our school, saying seniors, stay strong. And that was very kind and very generous of you guys to be able to like congratulate and support each other during a very difficult, stressful time of your academic career when you're applying for colleges.
Although each of you like belongs to kind of a friend group, those friend groups interrelate and don't separate themselves. They actually come together.
Bo Wilkie, in my artifact lesson, dismantling my juju pet. I never was able to rebuild it.
When you guys were sophomores, you pulled your money together and bought me concert tickets. Just because you remembered, like I was, I mentioned like months earlier, like I really liked a certain band, and then you you just surprise me at the end of the year with that, and that was like one of the best experiences I've had as a teacher.
It could be Leo's promposal.
They're actually interesting to watch. In years past, it seemed more about the student themselves, but you guys, it's like a pageant, and it's almost so unique to watch your promposals.
Notice the podium. It's the last lecture you're going to get from this podium, and I'm using it as a sign of respect.
I think I'm going to miss the kind of like sense of that, like the comfort that comes with kind of knowing everyone in your grade.
I'm going to miss like the small community and how everyone is like really close in our grade. And I know like when we go off to college, it's not going to be
Maloney and Jose.
That's
Clint.
True.
Yeah,
true.
And the food truck. And Tony.
Tony
Hall.
You guys.
All of us.
And Mansdorf.
And Tanau.
Oh, Mr. Zio.
Each other.
Aww.
Wow.
Mansdorf.
Ms. Taylor.
Mark Triano.
Ms. Theodorado.
I wrote recommendations for about 40, even 50% of this class for college. And I already knew you were great history students, but I used the self-profile that you gave to Ms. Harris for background. And I was absolutely amazed by this class more than any class that I've taught before. The incredible range of interests and the internships and the wide variety of skills that this class has. You are painters, you're cellists, you're journalists, you're ballet dancers, you're computer scientists, you're social workers, you're PSAL athletes. In an age of hyper-specialization, when you're told over and over again to be pragmatic and to be practical, you guys are humanists. And if I have to give some advice for the future, it would be to keep your minds open, work hard, and keep that sense of adventure forever.
You guys have so much potential really to do whatever it is that you want to do. And I don't want any of you to ever feel like you're being held back by anything. So the best is yet to come.
Not everything in life is going to go exactly the way you want it to, but you have to make that situation happy for you. So when you go to college and you know, you take some classes and they're harder than you thought they were, you can't just give up and be miserable about it and think you weren't prepared or that you're not good enough to be there. You have to make your own happiness. You have to figure out, you know, how you can do well, or maybe, you know, explore a different topic. But ultimately in life, don't wallow. You can be upset for a day when things don't go your way, but then you have to move on.
Don't forget us. I hope you all come back to visit. You will have a home here at American Studies.
Try your hardest, be yourself, and be the best version of yourself that you can be in the process. And have fun.
I can't wait to see what you do in the next 4 years.
I ain't too sure what I believe in, but I believe in what I see. And when I close my eyes, I see my whole life ahead of me.